let's get set to go racing. Four fastest cars in our street stock division. Four laps of racing. Pole position. And to turn one, Glenn holding on to that inside position. Price in the Camaro slips by to pick up second place. Standifer and Littorino going on the inside of Graham Nova. And they do the shuffle with Price on the outside. Torino, Graham right behind him. These cars just running bumper to bumper. And Standifer in the Torino now trying the outside line on Shuri's Cutlass. Price holding on for third place, but Graham giving him a run for it. Full, squeezing out to the inside, and Bingham just doesn't have much of an opportunity to do much racing, but this is his second night in the car. Al Berkey giving the ride to Don Price. That piece of machinery, my goodness. We're going to tell you more about that in just a couple moments as they wheel around in turn three and four. There he is out of the car. Let's give him a Redwood Acres welcome to Don Price. Hey, Don, can we still call you Mud Hen? No, he says that's okay. That was one of his nicknames when he was racing back. Finishes in main events. Up until that time, Walker had been the only car to finish every single main event this year. And of course, now we have no cars that have finished every single main. So here they come out of three and four, looking for the green side by side. O'Neill on the inside. There's the green. Bill O'Neill, Marcelli on the outside. Price holding on and pulling into second place. Marcelli caught on the outside. That's a tough place to be, but that's a place faster qualifier. Bill O'Neill, Jim Walker, and Randy Olson bumper to bumper through turn one and two. Marcelli slipping back to fourth place and still trying to hold that line on the top. Holding that inside line. Walker will stay right with him. Now Olson tries the top side, and that can be kind of tough. White flag is out. And we'll watch and see if the Olson Camaro can make the handle through turn one and two. O'Neill hanging on. Olson down the back straightaway, right up against the wall. Walker tries to squeeze in. Not much racing room. And here we are on a turn four. Checkered flag. At the line, Olson picks up second place by a 6 inches over Jim Walker and Angelo Marcelli. You know, Bill, you keep telling me about who owns the car. I'm going to ask all the fans in the stands after the racing is over tonight to run down and ask you who really does own the car. That'll teach you to tell me that. He says he doesn't know. And once again, our friends from the Coast Guard from the National Guard out there in the 8-wheel drive. 1,000 pounds, the payload. And this is basically used for supply. It'll go through 4 feet of water. You could ford a pretty good-sized stream. Chevelle Richard Butler. First of what should be two 10-lap heat races in our street stock division. And lights are out. We'll look for a green this time around. Gary O'Neill will look him over. Thomas on the inside leads him around. Bonnie on the outside. Here they come on the gas. There's a green. Thomas holding that inside line in the Nova. Look at that traffic jam in turn one and two. Randy Dean in the three car. The Pontiac trying to pull alongside Cotapassi in the 47 Dodge Charger. And these cars very evenly matched as Thomas leads them back to the line. And now Dean into turn one and two. We got a little bit of debris that came off one of the cars, but it came down on the inside, not on the racing surface. I think that was off the three car, making a little contact out there as Thomas leads him around. Cotapassi hanging on for second. Dean takes it way. Into turn one. Let's see if they all make it. And Butler from the back of the pack. Richard Butler sneaking up on the leaders. Butler in the Chevelle. And look out over in turn four. Red flag is out on lap number three. And a tough break for Mark Murray in the 71 car. Look at the tail end of that car, and Thomas in the 18 car. You could almost see that one coming. No problem. And you can see Thomas walking around the back of the car. He may be a little shook up. Punctured, you do not have a massive fuel spill, which of course can be disastrous. One of the major concerns in all types of automobile racing, car racing, is threat of fire. And that has been, for the most part, almost eliminated with the use of fuel cells. Occasionally you will see fires and disappears rather quickly. You don't have the massive fuel fires that were so tragic many, many years ago in all types of racing. And there is Mark Murray in the 71 car. And Butler in the Chevy tries the outside line. McGowan on the inside. Down the back straightaway. Trying to sneak up on the outside of that Dodge Charger. Cotapassi using the racetrack very well. The Chevelle takes it high. This time he might have the edge on Cotapassi. Right up against the wall down the back straightaway. And Butler will make the pass this time around. McGowan in that big Impala. To make a move on Cotapassi, tries the outside line. Dean in the Pontiac holding on for fourth. Butler starting to pull away from the rest of the field. And we're halfway there. And once in a while, you see some sparks down there in turn one and two. Usually, that's actually the chassis of the car bottoming out on the racetrack. It's not you. And gives Cotapassi a little hello tap on the bumper. Let's watch him over there down the back straightaway. And Richard Butler says, hey, I've got this one to myself so far as he comes around. And Randy Dean trying to make a show as McGowan looks on the inside of Cotapassi. He squeezes up there. Not much running room. Those cars making contact. Cotapassi puts him right in the dirt. I'm going to let go. And now Cotapassi out of shape. McGowan also tags him. And back to the line. We go yellow. Dean will be in second place. We race back to the yellow. And Bonnie beats out Cotapassi. And McGowan now stopped on the racetrack. Down in turn four, back under his own power, apparently, as he tries to wheel his way around. Green and white is out, 1 minute to go. And Butler once again trying to stretch out that lead. He doesn't want to get tangled with anybody behind him. McGowan now trying to make a move on Bonnie's Cutlass and doesn't find any racing room there. Out of turn place over Mac McGowan. Here he is out of the car, Richard Butler. And this time, our trophy presenter, Dana Smith, says, I'm going to walk out here. I'm not going to ride in that big, huge vehicle anymore, for a while anyway. Street stock division. Remember, points awarded in our main events only. And Standifer just 4 points behind Richard Butler. Butler with 240 away from Fair Oaks, California, down in the Sacramento area. Rick Catalana. And the 05 car, Bill O'Neill in the winner's circle earlier tonight. 25 Angelo Marcelli, 48 Jim Walker, 17 Randy Olson, and 21. In the K car in fourth is Catalano, picks up third base. And Bradbury in the 40 car trying to put some distance between himself. He knows those faster cars are behind him. Markin doing an excellent job of hanging on to second base. Now Catalano on the inside picks up second place. Gets into third, Markin falling back quickly. Baldwin holding on for fourth, and Marcelli pulls it to fifth. car, Rusty Olsen, through turn three and four. We're not going to see a start this time. Lights, come on. Understand the 16 car, Rusty Olsen is not racing for points tonight. Three and four, there's the green. And some of the cars caught napping as they get on the gas. Watch that traffic jam and see if everybody makes it through one and two. Dean and the Pontiac leads him down the back straightaway. Tim McCracken moving up very quickly on the outside of Butler Chevelle. The two Chevelles almost side by side. Your second fast qualifier trying to make his way through the pack. He doesn't want Standifer to get away from him. Three abreast to turn three and four. Standifer gets on the outside of Butler. And McCracken leads him down the back straightaway. Randy Dean holding on for third place as Butler tries the outside. John Price in the low car trying to make his way through traffic. The line, look at that map. Into turn one and two, Butler trying the outside line as Olsen in the 16 car retiring into the infield. And now Price has picked up third place, but he gets into Dean just a little as he makes his way around. A real traffic jam for fourth place on back. McGowan in the 27 car into the infield, and the leaders come back to the line. We will show a yellow racing back to the line, but Bracken holds on for the lead. And Tim McCracken will be your leader, then Standifer in 55, the number one Camaro of Don Price. And Standifer actually probably does not want to see that yellow flag come out, because you know that second fastest qualifier. To see those top three cars try to break away from the rest of the pack as Graham also trying to get up there with the leaders. McCracken leads him around once again. Standifer looking to make a move right behind him. And McCracken starting up front using that racetrack as Standifer gives him a little bump just to let him know he's there. Shaking that warning flag at Standifer for bumping into McCracken, and he'll try it again. Comes right up on his bumper, leaves an inch between him. Don Price, Eric Graham, waiting to make their move. Top four cars, very competitive tonight. And now Standifer decides to swing out and try that outside line. Don Price slips in on the inside. Price diving down the back straightaway. Three abreast, Don Price, Tim McCracken. Back to third, McCracken back to fourth. And traffic flag out as the leaders come up on the back of the pack. Don Price, Eric Graham, Standifer trying on the inside of Graham's Nova. And the fifth place car right now is Del Biagio, the number 19 car. Number 12, we're not even halfway there yet. And Price moves on the inside of Bonnie Stepper. Standifer follows him through. Fifth place car, Del Biagio at the line, followed by Fury, and then Dean and Parker. As the leaders make their but Don Price, a lot of experience. They come up on Randy Dean in the three car and Cortopassi once again. Eric Graham going third. A track in the fourth. The other gear is still hanging on to the fifth. And Price in traffic makes his way through and starts to put a little distance between himself and Standifer. Graham also staying right with him in the Nova. Cortopassi retiring in the Dodge Charger. This is the way things went last week with Graham running second. Price and Del Rey starting to go as Graham hands it back. And now the leader is coming up on Butler and Bonnie. Richard Butler in that battle for the track championship would like to keep those faster cars behind him. To the outside. Make some work for it as the leaders try to make their way around. And top three cars down. Everybody on the racetrack almost. And Price the inside line. At the line doesn't quite make it. Price is now shut out down the back straightaway. Standifer makes the pass. Lap number 21. And we've got 9 laps of racing to go. Standifer in the Ford Torino showing the strength of that race car once again tonight as the Fords gobbling up the Chevys. And Standifer moves on the inside of Sherry. Don Price trying to follow him through. He'll watch traffic very closely. Squeezes by. Takes to the outside line. Standifer moves on the inside. In the 28th car for 5th place, and Randy Dean in the 3 car for 6th place. The leaders coming around for the start of lap number 25. And if they should finish the way they are running right now, Standifer would take over the points lead for the 88 track championship. Butler has been caught in traffic. He's a lap down to the leaders. And Don Price unable to make up some of that ground on Standifer. Third place car, Harry Graham, working some heavy traffic as he tries to make a move on the outside of Dennis Del Biagio. Standifer with lots of running room, no traffic in front of him. He may be able to finish his race. And we'll come around with 2 more laps to go. Standifer really on the gas, stretching out there for the top three cars. 55-1-4. Quickly down the back straightaway. Price in the Camaro does not have enough racing time to catch up with it. Out of turn four. Checkered flag. Ben Standifer. Don Price. Third place car. Eric Graham. And then I think we've got to go all the way back to Tim McCracken in the 28 car, but that'll be unofficial. Tim Standifer. Arthur. And if you think driving one of these race cars is all that easy, even some of the most experienced drivers out here, when they run these 30 and 40 lap mains, get out of the car and they say they work hard. Tremendous centrifugal force involved as you go through the turns. The ultimate in concentration, you just can't even stop to think about it. In so many other sports, you have timeout and the action stops for a moment and everybody gets gathered back up. In a race, in a car race, you don't have that type of thing. You got to be on the gas and working the brain cells the entire time, or you're just not going to be there. And Jim Walker in the 48 car on.
Yes!
No kiss, though? No, I don't think so.
Here he comes.
Any kind of terrain. First time I saw one, I looked at that and I said, gee, it looks like almost like something out of Star Wars, you know, with that cab up front there. And there is Dana. Dana Smith out for the official presentation. I asked these folks from the National Guard, well, what would be the value of a vehicle like that? I mean, what does it cost the government? Number one car, first time on the racetrack. Rick Catalano from Sacramento, they're bunching up, starting to get on the gas at 3 and 4. Watch it closely out of turn 4. Generally, the Flagman will watch the top 4 to 6 cars, and we like to see them just about 2 by 2 lined up rather nicely before we turn them loose. This time they look real nice. Let's see if they can hold that position as we come around this time around. Once again, there's the green. And Redwood very quickly trying to move up front. Catalano follows in through. Redwood and Catalano breaking away from the Brazil. Barcelli picks up third place. Goes to fifth place. Marcelli, a little problem as Mark Baldwin slides into the infield. We stay green. And Redway is back to line. And Redway squeezes back to the inside of the racetrack. Now Olsen and Walker both working on Marcelli. As Olsen goes high, and Joe Marcelli in the car stays on the inside. Away from the rest of the pack. Walker now challenging. Rick Catalano, the one get that inside spot. And this time he might have it as he moves up into third place. And now the leader, Olsen, will be moving into third. They've been there before. And Walker's winning by on the outside. And Olsen, once again, working his way through traffic, goes to the outside of Baldwin in the K car, slips by the inside of Berkey in the 21 car. Now with almost a straightaway lead as Walker starts flicking through traffic. Third place, Dan Bradbury, an excellent top qualifiers have gotten around him, but that car holding very well. Speed as the leaders come around the outside. Olsen goes to the outside of Park, and Jim Walker may be catching up with him. final scoring is correct, Dan Bradbury would hold on to first place. So, unofficially, Bradbury finishing third in the pulley car, running an excellent program tonight. And once again, the 17 Camaro stringing a lot of main event lasts. So, you folks are... trophy presenter tonight, Dana Smith. And once again, I'd like to thank our friends from the Army National Guard. Let's give them a big round of applause for bringing that vehicle all the way up from Santa Rosa just for tonight. And also a reminder, our friends from the CB Patrol, Pacific Redwood Breakers, handling the traffic and parking. Please obey their instructions so everybody can get here from the parking lot to their respective streets and make their way home safely. And trophy presentations being completed. On behalf of Redwood Acres Raceway and the Winston Racing Series, we'd like to thank you for being with us here for our program, and we'll see you 1 week from tonight, next Saturday night, right back.